When magical items get eaten, well, hello. This is Weslyn from Woven Within, and I put the dogs in my van just on trust, and my brother's dog ate my smudge van that I made from scratch, and also a bunch of other pieces of taxidermy that are really important to me because I'm pagan and I'm vegan. So for me, part of my magic and ritual and spells and all of that is absolutely using taxidermy. However, it's only from naturally found animals that have passed on their own time. And so I have an incredible taxidermy artist at Aeon Gallery, and so I'm gonna give her a big shout out, Cheryl_AeonGallery. I'm gonna come visit you soon because I need some more of your art, and thank you for doing what you do. Aeon Gallery, by the way, is back in Illinois, and it's fantastic. Definitely check them out online. Because they do a million things. Oh, tattoos. This is Zamia Flesh. Zamia and Cheryl own it together. Anyways, a big shout out to them. And I am breathing with this one. I reached out to a very dear friend, and he explained to me that they ran away, that their spirits needed to be freed, and it's not that I was using them too much with magic or too little or too many spells or too anything. It's just that when someone serves their life's purpose, be it in the flesh or in the afterlife, there are new and more levels of freedom. And I thought that was a really beautiful way to look at it. And I'm also opening the space now to create new magical items. I have an antler up there that I'm gonna make into a pagan staff and make myself a wand. And yeah, I'm going to flip this from, oh, woe is me, this is so sad that this is gone. Literally, it's eaten, gone. I'm gonna flip that into being very motivated to make more magical items and dance with them and show them and post them on my blog more often. And then maybe even start passing them on, and trading for things and selling them and anything like that. Just to keep the magic flowing so that no one has to sacrifice themselves. Yeah. Crying over chewed up smudge fans. Hashtag witch life, I guess. with any magical item, remember that the magic still exists even when the item is gone physically, just like people, and that's that whole life cycle. So wherever you are, smudge fan, I love you so much, and stay tuned for me making more magical items and figuring out how to store things in my van. Have a magical day, guys.